Hello and welcome into On the Clock. I'm Jordan Ziegler, as always, joined by Dylan Vanderveen and Aiden Pezel. We have another great show for you this week. I'm a little embarrassed to be opening the show because I'm so far behind everyone on the scoreboard right now. I think I got like 2 points last week. Aiden is still leading us, I believe, with 54 points. And then Dylan Vanderveen hot on his tail with 41 points. And then I have a meager 28. So not doing so well. Looking to turn things around, though. I have a lot of high-risk, high-reward picks that could yield a lot of points for me this week. But anyway, without further ado, Aiden, how are you going to start us with your picks for this week?
Well, I thought no better way to start it than, once again, talk about a sport I know nothing about. Baseball. We're back at MLB.
Gotta love it. Gotta love it.
But we're taking the hottest team in the MLB. We're parlaying that with the no-runs first inning, the lone shark in the MLB, the Tampa Bay Rays. They are 13-0, started off the season insanely hot, and I have no reason not to continue just to ride them until the wheels fall off. Now, we're parlaying that with the no-runs first inning, and so far on the show, I'm 2-0 on the Nerfies. So, realistically, I got nothing to lose. I'm up, I think it's 14 points on Dylan right now, and I need this parlay to hit and just to really solidify this win this year.
Yeah, the only problem I have with that one is Berrios also is 0-2 with over 11 ERA this year and two starts. That's on the Blue Jays side, not on the Rays side. So, I mean, I'd be a little bit worried about that in the run first inning, maybe Rays jumping on him early, but, I mean.
The Rays also have scored a lot of runs in the first inning this year as well, so.
You're about to be 2-1 on the Nerfies. Basically, we're saying you're about to be 2-1 on the Nerfies, is basically what we're saying.
That one might have required a bit more research.
Yeah, maybe. Too bad I know nothing. But that's okay. We got Drew Russman, who's 2-0 on the season.
And so, still at least on the name.
The Rays side. I just don't know, but at least on the Rays side, we'll be all right. Now, we're getting away from the MLB. These guys over here, Dylan and Jordan, know way too much about MLB compared to me. So we're gonna go over to the NBA. We got the play-ins today, and we're going with some player props. We're taking DeMar DeRozan over 21.5 points, and this guy has averaged 21 points per game this entire season. So realistically, his floor is 18, his ceiling's probably 26. Now, DeMar DeRozan is a great player. This is a guy who's very consistent and finds his spots all over the floor, whether it's in the post or in the mid-range. And compared to his running mate, Zach LaVine's a guy who's very streaky. When he gets hot, he's hot. This is a guy that can go off for 30 or he can drop 10. Now, DeMar DeRozan's going to be a lot more consistent. He's going to be good for 20 at the very least. And we're getting this at minus 125, and I think this should be an easy win for us here. Now, for my next NBA pick, we're going with the same game parlay in the Thunder game. We're taking Shai Gilgeous-Alexander to hit 1-3, just one. And we're taking Karl-Anthony Towns over 22.5 points. Now, Shai's coming off a game where he just hit two threes. Now, he doesn't always take threes, but when he does, he's very efficient from around the perimeter. Now, Karl-Anthony Towns, he's playing the Thunder, who are the smallest team in the league. Their center is 6'7". This is a guy who played small forward in college. And now, in his rookie season, he's playing center. This should be an easy points for Karl-Anthony Towns. This is a guy who's going to get a lot of putbacks, and he's going to get a lot of shots around the perimeter, and this should be an easy hit.
Now, yeah, no, for sure. I mean, Karl-Anthony Towns and Rudy Gobert right there, like, versus the Thunder.
I know nothing about the NBA, so I'm not going to comment on
that. That's just not a good matchup for the Thunder. It's just not a good matchup for him.
Yeah, fair enough. But even with Shai, too, he only needs 1-3, and this is a guy who scores a lot of his points in the paint. That's going to open up the perimeter a lot for him. So I'm hoping it's just one. We just need one. And we're getting that at plus 125, and that's it for the rest of my NBA picks.
Veen?
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to choose a different sport that we kind of went away from since Jackson left the show. Rest in peace, Jackson, over there. Didn't die, but he's off the show.
Jesus.
So, I'm going to say, hey, Pezzle's blowing his lead right now. That's all I'm saying. But I'm going to take it to the ice first parlay. I'm going to go the Boston Bruins and the Carolina Hurricanes. They both play on Monday. They both start their playoff series on Monday. And they're two of the best teams in hockey. They play at home. The Bruins have lost 7 times at home this year in 41 games. That's ridiculous. Like, it's never been heard of. They got the most points, the most wins in NHL history in a single season. And the Hurricanes are arguably, like, the second best team. And they're a step down from the Bruins. But they're arguably the second best team. They play a Florida Panthers team that's been insanely inconsistent this year. And I don't see how that can really, like, miss, honestly, in my opinion, because this is the two best teams in hockey, and taking that wagon. If I miss that, I miss that. They're two best teams. I'm taking them in the first playoff game. Next one, I'm going to go the Rangers I'm in this. So that's a two-leg parlay locking in for 5 points. Then I'm going to take the Rangers on Tuesday to win away at the at the New Jersey Devils. The Devils are a very struggling team at home this season. They're just under 500 at home, or just over 500 at home this season. The Devils are. They're a better team, I think, than the Rangers, in my opinion, overall. But I think that they're going to drop one at home here with the Rangers having the experience they have. I think Patrick Kane's going to help them a lot in the playoffs. So I think that Rangers is going to just take a win right there.
Yeah, I don't like that.
I don't know. It's a gutsy. It's a gutsy call, but I don't hate it.
Yeah, I'll give them that much.
Yeah, for sure. But come on. Patrick Kane in the playoffs. I love Patrick Kane. Everybody knows all about Patrick Kane. I love the Blackhawks, so everybody knows I love him. And I'm going to take the Maple Leafs, which is going to leave some sour lemony taste in everybody's mouth. You know what I'm saying? Like, Maple Leafs in the playoffs, man. They're known to choke in the playoffs. But I think they're going to take the game here against the Lightning. The Lightning are an under 500 team on the road this season. 18-22 and one on the road this season. The Maple Leafs are a very, very good team at home. I'll take them in game one. And then I'm going to go ahead and put it on the diamond with MLB picks. I got to do it, obviously. I love the MLB. Yeah. It'd be just a sin for me not to take an MLB pick.
Wrong.
Just be wrong, yeah. Like, yeah, I mean, just wrong. But I'm going to take hang on, sorry. Give me 1 second. Just, my bad.
Yeah. He knows a lot about the MLB. Don't even worry about it.
I had it pulled up.
Oh, okay.
Oh yeah, it's just like right around here, right around the corner.
Oh yeah,
sure. So I got. You're doing great, Dylan.
My bad. I'm sorry.
There you go.
I had the Orioles and White Sox. That game's gonna go over 8 runs. The White Sox bullpen has been like disastrous at every single aspect in there. I mean, they have an over 8 ERA through 12 games this season. That's ridiculous. Awful. I mean, that's like almost unheard of. The Orioles have been really hitting the ball very well. Mountcastle's been hitting insanely well. Rutschman looks like he's gonna be the best catcher in his first full season.
Yep.
So I'm going to take the over there. I'm going to parlay that with.
Oh, my goodness.
Dude.
Dylan, what are we doing today?
I'm sorry, boys.
Looking for that parlay, you know? We just got to have it.
I'm sorry, boys.
Anything for the lock.
I don't know why my picks keep, leaving me. Oh, I'm going to go. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm going to go Mets money line against. Against the Oakland Athletics. Obviously, the Oakland Athletics, I don't even need to go over their team. They're horrible. But they got Senga on the mound tonight, which is that ghost fork ball.
Ghost
pitcher.
Fork.
I love it. I mean, I watched it when he struck out 8 against the Marlins. I think it's insanely impressive. It's kind of a pitch you don't really see. So I love watching him. I'll watch that game tonight, and I'll take that on the last parlay.
Well, you need it. If you're going to catch me with what a great lead I got, you need them all.
You've been on the show for 2 weeks.
I'll take it. 4 runs in the first inning this year.
Oh, wow.
All right, Ziggy.
Okay, I'm going to go back to a guy who I took for the Masters. It's Jordan Spieth plus 2,000 to win the RBC Heritage. He won the tournament last year. He played really good at the Masters, got third. I love that pick. Jordan Spieth, lock it in. I'm going to move on to baseball. Of course, I have to do it. Royals money line plus 125. Only reason I'm taking this, it is against the Braves, which is mildly concerning, but Brady Singer is on the mound for the Royals, and he's had 2 rough starts to start the year. But if you look at what he did last year, all his StatCast metrics suggest that he's a very good pitcher. He's going to have a good start, win that game for the Royals. Then finally, I got the Dodgers, minus 1.5, plus 125. They're playing against the Cubs. Ooh. I had to do it just to do it to Veen. They're
Justin
playing against
Steele's
the Cubs.
Gonna shut them down.
Anyway, they're gonna go 5 and dive. Noah Syndergaard. Then the bullpen's gonna come in. Dodgers are gonna win by 3 runs. That's what I got. We're gonna go to a short break, and then we have NBA futures coming up with the playoffs starting after this.
37% of teens are cyberbullied. 95% of teens say they have an online presence. 23% of students say they have bullied someone. Before you post, think, is it true? Is it helpful? Is it inspiring? Is it necessary? Or is it kind? For more information, visit stopbullying.gov.
For students searching for a way to stay active in an outdoorsy way, the City of Lawrence has bike trails running in every direction, and with the new Bike Share program, we can stay in shape as we tour the sights of our beautiful city. Clinton Lake is only a short 30-minute bike ride away from Daisy Hill and has the most incredible sunset location in all of Lawrence. Walking campus may give you the KU calves, but biking can give you the KU thighs. Bike Lawrence today.
Welcome back to On the Clock, and as Pezzle mentioned, maybe we know a lot about the MLB, but we're gonna go to a sport here for our just picks here with the NBA. Not a sport that I really love, but you know what? We're gonna roll with it anyway. So I'm just gonna go ahead. I'm gonna send that over to Jordan to give you his picks.
Yeah,
for sure.
I mean, I'm the least knowledgeable NBA person in this room, so I'm just gonna throw stuff out there and hope for the best. I have two futures, both to win the NBA Finals, one out of the West and one out of the East. We'll start in the West. I got the Sacramento Kings plus 8,000. They've been knocking it out of the yard this year
they
as
still
a
have
team.
The experience.
It is, you know, a team, and here's why. I have a cousin that goes to UC Davis in California. And that is very close to the city of Sacramento.
I know a guy who knows a guy.
and so he's been to a few Kings games this year. And from what he has told me, he said they were fun. And therefore, that's why I got
it. So they're fun, so therefore they're going to win.
I have no reason behind this whatsoever.
I bet the value's amazing, though.
Yeah,
plus 8,000.
Goodness.
I know they're historically bad. I know they had a pretty long playoff drought before this year. That's all the logic I have behind it. And then next out of the East, I have the Celtics at plus 310 to win the finals.
Yeah, love that.
That one, I actually do think I know a bit more about. Obviously, they were in the finals last year and lost to the Warriors.
And over the Bucks, though.
I know Jason Tatum is one of the best players in the NBA. Yes, they were able to beat the Bucks last year. So
without Chris Middleton?
Okay. I don't know much about Chris Middleton's game, to be 100% honest with you. The Celtics are cool. They're historically great. I like their uniforms. My grandpa's a Celtics fan, so.
Enough said.
That's all the reasoning I can provide for this. Who's next?
I'll take this over. I'm gonna go the opposite of Ziggy. I'm gonna go with the Milwaukee Bucks to win the title. The Milwaukee Bucks are, like, I mean, they're just a great, unbelievable team this year. They look better than when they won the title a couple years ago. They've got their whole team healthy. They've got a lot of depth. Brooke Lopez has been amazing for them, which is like, could be sixth man of the year, could be defensive player of the year. I mean, he's definitely in the talk for both of them. All these players, along with Giannis, just coming together at the end of the year, taking over the one seed over the Celtics. I see them winning the NBA title for sure. That's going to be one. The other one, I'm going to go with this series that's going to start now. It's going to be the Memphis Grizzlies and the LA Lakers. And I say that series is going to go six games or more. The Lakers are going to beat the Memphis Grizzlies twice because LeBron James doesn't get swept out of the playoffs. That doesn't happen. One, that doesn't happen. Anthony Davis and if Anthony Davis and LeBron James can actually stay healthy throughout the playoffs, they actually might be able to win a series against someone like Memphis.
Wow, that's honestly insane. Like that's a pretty crazy take,
that's
to be
weird,
honest. But I don't hate it.
Like,
six games, that's 4-2.
To
that's nothing outlandish. I don't hate it.
He did this with the MLB playoffs in the first semester.
Yeah, and it hit.
And tell him how you feel, V. Well, for mine, I'm pretty much just picking the NBA Finals. We're taking Eastern Conference and Western Conference winners. We're going to start off with the Eastern Conference, and we're taking the Boston Celtics.
Yeah.
Now, this Boston Celtics core has been together since 2018. Since 2018, they've been to three Eastern Conference finals. Now, coming off last year, they folded pretty rough. Jason Tatum had one of the worst finals showings we've probably seen in a long time. Now, this year, they're desperate, and they're really looking to win it all. Now, at this point, I don't have a finals winner yet, but I know they're going to make it past the Eastern Conference finals this year. So for the other side, we're going to the Western Conference, and we're taking the Phoenix Suns. Now, listen, they have everything to lose here. They got all the talent. This is the most complete team in the NBA from 1 to 5. We're talking DeAndre Ayton at center, who can be soft at times. Then when you got a veteran point guard in Chris Paul, who's a floor general, who's going to facilitate each and every time down the court.
Who chokes in the playoffs.
But who's it better to pass to than Devin Booker? Oh, and they also got this other guy, I forgot his name. Oh, like maybe like the best scorer of all time in Kevin Durant. They have everything to lose in this series. And realistically, I don't see the Nuggets doing it. I don't see any team in California doing it.
The Kings.
Exactly. I just don't see it happening. But I think that's going to be the finals matchup. I think that's really going to be Celtics and the Suns. And we're getting one at one plus 55 and the other one at plus 190. And then for our next segment, we're going to go over to our squad ride. Now, last week was our first segment of this. Started out pretty
rough.
Didn't
work well.
We went 0 for 1.
We saw no hole in one. I was so disappointed.
What a story would have been.
Yeah. But then this week, we're looking to come back for you guys and really get an absolute lock on the table.
We have a voluptuous Nerfy coming up right now.
Oh, yeah. Dylan, tell him.
Yeah, we're going to go with this Nerfy. Obviously, you got to go Nerfy for baseball if you're going to take a squad ride. It's amazing. I love them. So we're going to go the no-run first inning in the Brewers and Padres game tonight. Mm-hmm. Michael Wacha's on the mound. Eric Lauer's on the mound for the Brewers. Yep. Both those pitchers. Lauer's had a little bit of a rough start to the season.
It's free.
But I think Lauer's going to bounce back tonight. Wacha's been solid for the San Diego Padres. So at least through one inning, I think that game is going to stay low. No runs,
first inning.
Yes, sir. Need it.
Absolutely.
We do need it.
We need it.
Please.
But that's all we have for you today, or for today on the Clock. Tune into us next week, and make sure you're checking out our social media page for our locks throughout the week and any other things that we post about this show. But other than that, we'll see you guys next week.